annoying girl running toward me from the distance, waving her arms in the air like she's totally oblivious to any attention she might draw to herself. That girl is Ayori, my neighbor, and a good friend since we were children. You know, the kind of friend you'd never see yourself making today, but it's just kind of worked out because you're knowing each other for so long. Yeah, I'm not really one from many friends. But if you're going to chase after me like this, I almost feel better off running away. However, I just sigh and idle in front of the crosswalk and let Sayori catch up to me. Don't take that out of context.
I overslept again! But I caught you this time.
Maybe. But only because I decided to stop and wait for you.
Yeah? You say that like you were thinking about ignoring me. Baka. That's just me, creepy.
But if people stare at you for acting weird, then I don't want them to think we're a couple of them.
Fine.
Like Like Loki in Infinity War, watch your words carefully. For those of you who trust me, right? If those of you got that reference, I'm sorry. If those of you didn't get that reference, I'm also sorry. Don't make me keep worrying about you. Tell Sayori, you don't need to worry about me. You just need to worry about your mental health. I mean yourself. I mean, alright. I'll look at a few cups. That's not what a cup is. I'll get a webcam. Whatever. I'll look at a few clubs if it makes you happy. No promises, though. Would you at least promise me you'll try a little? Yeah, I guess I'll promise you that. Yay! Oh, joyous days! You'll be a part of the literary club. That's not the right one. The literature club. Probably. Why do I let myself get lectured by such a carefree girl? Right, carefree. Sure. I know I'm thinking on the back of the literature, but nobody's watching, so it doesn't really matter. More than that, I'm surprised I even let myself. I guess seeing her worry so much about me makes me want to ease her mind at least a little bit, even if she does exaggerate everything inside her head. And that one person left. Packing up my things, I stare blankly at the wall, looking for an ounce of motivation. Club. Sayori wants me to check out the club. I guess I have no choice because I was behind my game. Hello? Sayori? Sayori must have come into the classroom while I was spacing out. I look around and realize I'm the only one left in the classroom. I thought I'd catch you coming out of the closet. What are we doing in there? No. Coming out of the classroom, but I saw you just sitting there spacing out, so I came in. That's what he said. Anyway. Honestly, you're even worse than me sometimes. You don't need to wait up for me if it's going to make me late to your club. Well, I thought you might need some encouragement, so I thought I'd let you know. Know what? Well, that you could come to my club. And come on. What? Ever aware she had any literature. In fact, I'm 99% sure she only did it because she thought it would be fun to help that new club. Then she was the first one to show interest after the one who promised the club. thought that's it coming. C-U-M-M. I can't tell if Theory is that much of an airhead or if he's so cunning as to have planned this all out. I think it's a little bit of both. A letter long side. I think with that side, we open a hot air balloon. And thus, today marks the day I sold my soul for a cupcake.
But it was laced with cocaine.
Cocaine's been a hell of a drug. I dejected I'm sorry, I'm coincidentally illiterate, essentially. Well, somewhat. Followed Sayori across the school and upstairs, a section of the school I rarely visit, being generally used for third year classes and activities. Sayori, full of energy, swings open the classroom door.
Hey yo, what's up, bitches? Everyone, the new club member is here.
Whatever. I told you don't call me a new club member. Around the room. Welcome to the club.
Where did you shoot this? Welcome to the club. Sayori always says nice things about you. Seriously, you brought a boy? Way to kill the apple.
Large class. Oh, except one of the main characters.
looking at. If you want to say something, say it.
Sorry.
Natsuki. Huh. Baka.
It's very difficult to make that noise. Crazy. We made room for you at the table so you can sit next to me and our mama. I'll get the cupcakes.
Hey, I made them. I'll get them. Baka.
Sorry. I get a little too excited.
Then, unicorn. So cute.
I had no idea you were so good at baking, Tatsuki.
Well.
No, that's not no.
Well, you don't know.
Because that's Natsuki. And, well, the stereotypical rich guy is.
BAKA!
Hitting the microphone. And, you know,
Ray smiles to herself in relief. Monica realizes, raises an eyebrow and smiles at her. If only her eyebrow can actually raise. So, what made you consider the literary club? It doesn't help that I'm technically whispering, considering I'm straining my voice like this. Thank you, Nevlings, for, you know. Monica is a really great leader. She provides us with all the cocaine.
What?
Cocaine's not a drug. Yuri also nods in agreement. surprised there aren't more people in Colombia. She wants to say something, but she keeps quiet. Not much of a reader, I guess. Well, that could change. What am I saying? I spoke without thinking after seeing your steps. Anyway, what about you, Gary? Well, let's see. Joey traces the trim of her She seems so reserved and someone as gentle as you. I guess you can say that.
No.
I guess you can say that.
Naturally, I guess you can say that.
Whatever.
Makes me think, or takes me to another world, then I can't really put it down. Oh, I'm so sorry. I had no idea. Let me raise the thing. You're gonna hear stuff in the background. I'm sorry about that. I have no idea how to fix that. I'm sorry. Oh my god.
Gladriel from Lord of the Rings.
And very successful at changing the way you look at the world, if only for a brief moment.
Ugh, I hate horror.
Oh, what's that?
Well, I just...
His eyes dart over to me, second person is that. Okay.
Never mind.
No.
Never mind.
Whatever. Never been able to do this successfully. Here it's wasted. That's right.
No.
Solid snake. That's right. You usually... usually like to write things about you, don't you, Natsuki? Tell me whether or not if I'm loud or a little bit in between. Go ahead, you can. I am up for stuff like that. What gives you that idea? Solid Snake. You left a piece of scrap paper behind last club meeting. Looks like you were working on a poem called.
Ha ha! Don't say it out loud. Say it that loud. And give that back.
Fine. Your cupcakes, your poems, everything you do, it just seems so cute as you are. Sayori slides up behind Natsuki and puts her hands on her shoulders.
I'm not cute, Baka.
Natsuki, you write your own poems?
Well, I guess I, I guess, sometimes. Why do you care? Fuck.
I think that's impressive. Why don't you share some sometimes?
No. Fuck you. Haha, fuck you, crazy.
Alrighty, alrighty, you don't have to. Sorry if I'm screaming. I probably should lower the volume. Okay, now it's great. More relatively similar sizes. That's what she said. Natsuki averts her eyes.
You wouldn't like them. You wouldn't like them.
Not a very confident writer, eh?
I understand how Natsuki feels. Sharing that level of writing makes you more than just confident.
Whatever, I missed that word.
The truest form of writing is writing oneself.
Sorry.
You must be willing to open up to your readers, exploiting your vulnerabilities, and showing even the deepest reaches of your heart.
Whoa, bro. That's like deep. Damn. You have writing experience too, Yuri.
Do you have writing experience too, Yuri? Maybe if you share some of your work with Solid Snake, you can set an example and help Natsuki feel more confident enough to share to
I'm not gonna pass the 20 follower barrier, am I? I guess it's the same for Yuri. An hour and a minute. An hour and a minute. Actually, that's a very different thing. I wanted to read everyone's poems. We all sat in silence for a moment.
Okay. I have an idea for everyone.
Natsuki and Yuri quizzily looked at Monica.
Let's all go home and write a poem of our own. Then, the next time we meet, we'll all share them with each other. That way, everyone is even.
Yeah, let's do it.
Plus, now that we have a new member, I think it will help us get a little more comfortable with each other and strengthen the bond of the club. Isn't that right, Crazy? Well, isn't that crazy? Ha ha, ha ha.
Monica smiles warmly at me once. Hold on, there's still one problem.
What's that?
Now that we're back to the original topic of me joining the club, I bluntly come forth with what I've been giving my entire time. Okay. I never said I would join this club. Sayori may have convinced me to stop by, but I never made any decision. I still have my other clubs to look at, and I lose my train of thought. Oh god, they're all looking at me. All four girls stare back at me with dejected eyes.
But I'm sorry. I thought.
Crazy.
You all. I'm defenseless against these girls. Just like real life. How am I supposed to make a clear-headed decision when it's all like this? When it's all about like this? No, when it's all... Whatever. Baka. Anyway, that is... If writing poems is the price I need to pay in order to spend every day with these beautiful girls, I wouldn't mind. Right. Okay, I've decided then. I'll join.
They keep leaving, and I'm sad about it.
I'll join the literature club. Everyone moved up at once. One by one, the girls' eyes lit up.
Yes, I'm so happy.
Zuri wraps her arms around me, jumping up and down.
Hey! You really scared me for a moment.
if you really just came here for the cupcakes, I would be super pissed. But appreciated considering the cupcakes. But appreciated considering you ate my pussy technically.
I think I pressed that twice.
Ben!
No.
Solid Snake! Ben! That makes it official. Welcome to the Literary Club.
Thanks, I guess.
Okay, everyone. I think with that, we can officially end today's meeting. On a good note.
Tonight's assignment. I probably shouldn't be doing that voice considering I have a film shoot tomorrow.
The next meeting, so we'll all share. Monica looked over at me once more. Crazy. I look forward to seeing how you express yourself. Hehe.
Yeah. I can really impress the class star Monica with my mediocre writing skills. I clearly feel the anxiety welling up inside me. Meanwhile, the girls continue to chit-chat as Yuri and Natsuki clean up their food.
Hey, Crazy. Since we're already here, do you want to walk home together?
That's right. Sayori and I have never walked home together anymore because she's always stayed at school for clubs. Sure, might as well.
Yay!
Time for... Alrighty, let me check a little something. Hold up a moment.
Bum 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 bum.
Well, fuck. Bring it a little closer. Alrighty, let's go back to it. With that, the two of us departed the club room and made our way home. The whole way, my mind wanders back and forth between four girls. Sayori, Natsuki, Natsuki, Sousuki, Yuri, and of course Monica. Will I really be happy? Will I really be happy spending every day after school in the literary club? Perhaps I will have the chance to grow closer to one of these girls. Preferably Natsuki, because anime. Ow, my arm. Oh, wait, what was that? I'll just need to make the most of my circumstances. And I'll make sure good fortune will find me. I'll make sure good...